at first they're just kind of like in awe. They've never seen anything like that before. I think he really loved it and kind of in awe of it all, I think.
There's just something magic about just Christmas lights when the lights are turned off, and every time parents and the kids walk in, just this amazement and awe comes over everyone, and it takes them a moment to take it all in, and then the energy is just up and everyone's running around and dancing and having a really good time. We could not have this fundraiser without our families, and it's been fun to not only have our families participate by donating, but actually come to the event. We had many parents dress up and do the run or dance with their child, so it was a good bonding moment and just bringing the community, all of us together.
So for us, the Glow Run happens in the dark, obviously. We always make some shirts that the kids work on together, and they're neon colors or glow in the dark. Lots of twinkle lights, some disco balls. We've got some freeze dance music going, and just kind of a fun atmosphere to get them moving. But we get to kind of incorporate our health and wellness indicators as well. The parents kind of join in. We encourage them to join in. The kids are always really excited about participating. This year we're very good about anticipating, so we use the calendar to count the number of days until the Glow Run, and they were ready to go.
Actually, I was here the very first year that we did the Glow Run. I was on the committee to get that started, and so it's really cool to see. That was, goodness, 5 years ago. Every year it just keeps getting better and better, and it's just such a fun opportunity for the kids to get some exercise and help raise money for the school.
So our goal of this fundraiser is really just to provide the best environment for our students. So to do that, we have asked for donations for playground enhancements, classroom resources, and building celebrations. We're putting it towards maintaining our playgrounds, finding some creative resources to put in the classroom, and then, as always, celebrating our students and our staff. We had the school board and the cabinet visit as well to give them a glimpse of what we do. Actually, one of our school board members, Heather Zromsky, she was our PTA president and originally brought this event to our school. Hopefully we're setting a very positive experience of the Nixa School District with these families, and just setting up a love of learning. And you know, some of our parents maybe didn't have the best experience in their own educational career, and so hopefully we can make them a partner and see that it can be different and kind of win them over and help them to love learning and school as well.